I am led to the golden rope by the creatures whose shadows step before they do. He walks out to the stones and sits down. His phone in his lap, tears rolling down his cheeks. He sits waiting for that one text. Once he reads it, everything is okay.
Wong was a very wealthy man. Wong was very successful, but he was always shadowed by his father, who was the king of Crawford. He would always be called the king's son, so he went to his father's palace to confront him. On his way there, he got tired and stopped at an inn. While he was sleeping, he had a dream. There was a god in the dream, and he floated down to Wong. He told Wong that if he ever wanted to be noticed by anyone, he would have to be patient.
really loves to dance. There is something about the way she dances. She dances in a hall that was filled with light. She spins. She finds her way to a room of rocks filled with light. She spins. She finds her way to a forest and leaps for joy. She dances with the grasses. Avery loves to dance. He grabbed his gun, took a shot, and heard a wince. He killed a wolf. He felt guilt. It was dark. He walked up to the wolf, moonlight shining in its eyes. He could hear its last breath. John lost a part of himself. He opened up the door and went inside without looking back.
It was rainy that day, and the old stone hates rain. I mean, not that it liked any weather, but at least it wasn't warm. He hates that too. To be honest, he doesn't like much. But he likes snow. To him, it feels like a blanket. Maybe this rain will turn into snow and cheer him up.
cold and unforgiving to those unprepared. The Rat King lay dormant in his lair. It is said that wherever the Rat King goes, blizzards, frostbite, and icy winds would follow. Children spoke about how years ago the Rat King chased away all the warm weather and now sleeps underground. It's cold.
Maybe I'll go back to sleep. What was that? I run after it. I wake up in a circle of rocks and moss. My hands are tired. Grab a rock and cut myself loose. I see it. I run up behind it and hit it in the back and run. I look back and hit a tree. I wake up in my bed. It was all a dream I told myself.
Yeah. Golden Brash was born in a yellow universe and was banished to ours for not being yellow. Golden Brash was green, green and mean. One day, Golden Brash came across a great big oak tree. It was in his way. He walked straight through that great big oak tree like it was nothing. He stepped into the ocean, and months later came out on the other side. He walked through the earth when it took the form of a mountain. He walked straight through the forests and their fires. He walked to the end of the world, where he found a little old man that begged him not to jump off. He kicked that little old man right off the edge and smiled as he fell into oblivion. Bold and Brash then did something so natural to him, it didn't seem bold or brash. He took a step, and the last things he saw were the stars.
I got in the taxi and told the driver to go home. He said, "Sure thing." We're driving, and I noticed that he passed my road. I thought to myself, maybe he's gonna turn around. The taxi stops, and the driver says, "We're here." I looked out the window and said, "This isn't my home." The driver said, "You said go home. You didn't say whose house."
I'll take your bow.
Some people just wrote totally new ones.
Yeah.
So it's kind of a mixture. Yes?
When did you guys start filming? Did you want to change your flash picture?
Some people. Yeah. Some people want to change theirs a little to match the movie.
Yeah. Like with Mackenzie's, we ended up changing the wands due to the mud. author?
Yeah. So that wasn't really the plan, but we thought, like, you know, plot twist.
How did
you
both
feel
about that?
Yeah.
So much variety here. We have so much great spaces to film. In my movie, I just went all around the campus. The area, just filming different sites and locations that I just thought looked nice and thought matched the movie. And I know a lot of different people did some similar. There was just a lot of great. Great spaces and great opportunities to get good shots. Lora and Bran helped us out a lot. I don't know if we'd be here without them, to be totally honest. But they helped us a lot with anything from filming to, camera advice. If we wanted a certain shot, they try and help us find what we wanted. They'd be willing to walk around the entire area with us just to find the right spot, and they really did give us good ideas and help us out a lot when it came to filming.
I've got a question for Eli. Eli, when you were running in that one film, where did you have the camera? Did you have it here? Were you holding it, or did you have it?
There was like this strap thing. And kept the GoPro right there on my chest.
That was great. And then Charlie and Eli, in that one you guys did, was that mistaken, or did a wolf kill a wolf? Did that ever happen?
Yeah.
At